The Atlantic puffin, one of the most endearing of birds. These birds are to be found on both sides of the Atlantic Ocean, with substantial breeding colonies in Newfoundland, Iceland, and the coasts of Northern Europe. One of the best places to see these birds in England are the Farne Islands, a half-hour boat trip from Seahouses on the Northumberland coast. There are estimated to be there during the breeding season about 36,000 birds. The puffins arrive there in March and April and leave in mid-August. The rest of the time, they are at sea. Accordingly, at the end of June 2008, I headed for the islands for a long weekend in order to see them. There is no tourist accommodation on the islands themselves, so I was to stay at Seahouses. Puffins frequently flap their wings. Sometimes this has no apparent purpose. Perhaps it is simply a little light exercise, or to shake the sea and rain from their wings. At other times, it is part of a threat display. A puffin will flap his wings over a burrow to mark his territory. Sometimes, by way of complete contrast, wing flapping is part of a courtship display, as here, where it is accompanied by billing. Puffins, of course, are not alone in indulging in billing when courting. This is a practice seen amongst many other birds, the most elaborate example being amongst the waved albatrosses in the Galapagos. A more unusual form of courtship display that puffins perform is the flicking of the heads back. This is done by the males. Again, the bobbing of the heads back has a parallel with behaviour to be seen in the Galapagos. This is something very similar to the sky pointing that we see from the blue and red-footed boobies there. Although I saw a good deal of courtship display on Inner Farne, in fact, most courtship occurs at sea. Courtship, though, is a game for grown-ups. In the case of puffins, most of them don't reach sexual maturity until they are 5 years of age, although some will start looking for a mate and prospecting for a burrow at 4. Before that age, they will remain at sea and not land at the breeding colonies. An average pair of puffins will successfully raise a single chick once every 2 years. The egg is laid in early May. Both male and female will take it in turns to incubate the chick for about 6 weeks. The newly hatched chick weighs about 35 to 45 grams and looks rather like a darkish grey powder puff, since the down is so long that it almost completely covers the small bill and the legs and feet. The chick remains in the burrow for about 6 weeks and reaches a weight of about 300 grams during this time. Both parents bring food to the chick. The commonest item is sandeels, which the parents catch by diving. Having caught a sandeel, it has to be held between the tongue and upper mandible, enabling the bird to catch another one and another. The normal number of fish carried back to the nest at each visit is about 10, but the world record is 80, which were small larval fish, recorded on an island in northern Norway. Most chicks receive some 5 to 8 feeds a day, each averaging about 8 grams.